everybody, this is KrebsCOHO. You might know me better as GenHansKrebs from the Company of Heroes forum. And I'm just going to be starting these replays for you guys just to show off my strategy. Any replays entertaining, if they are or not. Just so you guys can learn about Defensive Commander. I mean, that's why you guys are here watching it, right? It'd be interesting to see how you guys play the Defensive Commander as well, because I know there's so many strategies out there. I'm sure everyone wants to see them. So if you guys would like to, you could just send in your replays to me. My email's in the profile description, and hopefully I'll get around to commentating it. But anyway, I think we'll just get started on this game. And just before I start, I want to go into the tactical map, because this is Angleville. I'm sure a lot of you are familiar, but for the ones that aren't, I'll just switch this around a bit, just so that we are on the bottom. So this is where we're starting, here in this blue spot. That's our position. And our enemy is actually on the north side. So Angleville, quite a symmetrical map. So if you look on the left and right hand side, you've got these high munitions and field points. So that's what we're wanting to go for first, right? So let's just get started. If you just double backspace from that little scenic, beautiful picture, you will go back to normal view. Right, so immediately with my first pioneer, I'm sending him out to this point right here to capture this point. And my first pioneer that I build is a hero pioneer. It's a field pioneer. Absolutely great, guys. They can throw down these crippling traps for free every 10 seconds. And when somebody steps on them, they are pinned. And you notice that I also build one more pioneer. So with that first pioneer that I built, I'm getting down to Vermont quarters right away. It's important, and hold on, I'll just take off this fog of war so you guys can see what's going on. And with that second pioneer that I built, sending him to cap the manpower point just so I can connect it to this ammunition point. Just saves time first if you go for the long stretching farther point away and then connecting it with another pioneer. Just saves time. So if you just look at here, Lieutenant Airborne, he is a level 38 airborne commander. He's actually quite good. This was a challenge for him, but I think it was only a plus 2 challenge, so not that much. So I don't think we're that far away in skill rating. So he's just doing a standard start. Just going for barracks, getting riflemen, capping away, and well, good on him. It looks like he's actually starting with charismatic engineers. These guys you don't really have to worry about unless you've got one single pioneer squad that you're fighting against. Because, you know, if one pioneer squad of two guys versus five, you're not going to win that fight. So I'd always recommend taking at least Volksgrenadiers or two pioneer squads against these guys. But anyway, just carry on. So immediately from the start, I capped the ammunition point. That is going to be the center of our attention. These ammunition points are more important than the fuel. Why? Because ammunition is where we're our abilities come at. And if you look at our abilities, I'm just going to pause very quickly. My abilities are aggressive defense, comes out at command level 2 for the ammunition. Contracted reinforcements, 180 manpower. These guys are absolutely brilliant because they build you free bunkers that you don't even have to upgrade. They're not free, but they cost 150 manpower, but you don't have to invest 50 ammunition into them. So very useful guys to use in that late game when you want to cement down your control. And for the Fatherland, absolutely brilliant ability to keep your guys staying alive longer. 50 ammunition, recoup losses. These are used when it's a free ability, right? And it's just a way to get back resources. So anytime that your guys are dying, you flip this on and you get resources from them. Simple as that. And if you have Volksgrenadier squad, it has an escalating effect for each guy that dies. So escalating effect, you just get more resources and reactive artillery. Notice minus 65 ammunition. So that means I've barely invested any points into it. But I'll come back to that a little bit later. So anyway, let's just carry on with this replay. It's just the early game, so there's not much action going on right now. Just capping away. Your location captured. And now, see, Lieutenant Airborne is actually quite a smart player. He's not a newbie, as you would say, because this is when you can tell somebody's not a newbie, when they're going for the cutoff points. If you noticed on the mini-map, or the tactical map, actually, this point here is needed in order for you to get the resources from all these points over here. So if he cuts you off here, say bye-bye to those resources there. And if you notice from my Vermont quarters, the first unit that I built was a Fatherland HMG. So I quickly rushed him into this house to try and take out these guys. And when you're in building, you get a lot more defensive bonus. So these guys are absolutely fine. The SMGs are wearing away at these riflemen. And my pioneer's coming in to back them up. And these riflemen should really get out of here. I mean, this is a lose-lose situation for them. They should be getting out way earlier than this. And this is where Lieutenant Airborne is actually doing really well, as again, because he's cutting me off. If you see here, this is another manpower point cut off. And so he's just cutting me off.
Our supply lines are broken. We have territory out of supply.
And what am I doing to him? I'm doing the exact same. I'm actually cutting him off at his point, and he's just rushing away, trying to make sure that I can't cap this point, so he doesn't lose his resources. And he's a smart guy. That's what I meant. You know, he knows what he's doing, so I need to quickly respond to the situation. I need to respond to any threat, so I quickly grab up my Fallout MG, have it in the back, bring my Volksgrenadiers to the front. So when these guys are suppressed, I start closing in with my Volksgrenadiers. You have to notice the timing on these things. MG down first, at the back, suppress the guys, everything closes in. And just a little bit of skirmishes going on, and this is what I meant. Do not send pioneers against charismatic engineers. You won't win that fight. And here's Lieutenant Airborne being smart again by going around. Now this is going to be something very important. Whenever you see gladiator riflemen or any heroes coming at you, make sure, be aware that they have grenades, especially gladiator riflemen. As you see here, and I fail, bam. There's not much I can do there. I lost a unit very early, needlessly. And the only reason because of that was because he had a hero and he threw a grenade. So recognize when the heroes are on the field that you need to get away from them. They can throw grenades and kill your guys. It's just a little bit of skirmishing going on here. Riflemen are very good at close range, but it looks like I'm actually winning that fight. Not anymore if I'm retreating. I spoke a bit too soon. I'm actually getting down a bunker. So if you look read about my strategy or my guide on the forums, you notice that I said put down a bunker as soon as you can. I actually could have gotten this bunker a bit faster, but I said get a bunker down as soon as you have 50 ammunition so that you can get a medic bunker. This medic bunker is going to be really important, so you get your grenadiers later in the game, and those grenadiers are going to be your main anti-tank until tier 4, until you get the Panzer Command. So right now I'm just trying to recover. Lieutenant Airborne pretty much has dominant control of the map. He's got the VPs, all three actually, and you can see my points going from 403 to, well, down, from 500 down.
One of our sectors has
been cut off. So I just need to recover right now. But to be honest, right now I'm not really worried. I mean, I've got a medic bunker coming down really soon. I've got a lot of guys. I've got all these Volksgrenadiers. And there's not really much to worry about. And I'm just going to pause this for a second, right? Let's take a look at these guys' army items. So for my Volksgrenadiers, I've got decreased reinforcement cost. The reason I get so many army items from my Volksgrenadiers is because the Volksgrenadiers are going to be staple army units that you use throughout the game. You need these guys in order to successfully use the recoup losses in order to, you know, tech up fast. So anyway, back to army items. So decrease reinforcement cost by 30%, increase health the squad's health by 24%, and if you notice, that's actually purple or pink. I can't actually differentiate between colors like that so well, but that's plus 24%. That's actually an epic item. But you can easily get a more common one, plus 16% from the shop. There's also increased weapon accuracy by 9%, and we've also got ability munitions cost reduced by 30%, so the Panzerfaust comes out much faster. Or much cheaper, should I say. So here, I'm not really too worried. Why? Because riflemen, American riflemen are actually really bad at long range. You can just notice all these bullets like hitting the ground, straying everywhere. They're not even hitting my guys. But Volksgrenadiers are really good at long range. See, my guys just owning them. Don't have to worry. These guys are sound. These guys were actually going and flanking them, taking them out on the side. See what's happening here. See, he's actually taking this house. He's capped this point again, cutting me off. He's taking this house and put riflemen in it. But notice what I do here. This is actually a bit of a useful tip for Angleville. put you guys here if you ever see guys, the enemy taking occupation of this house. Because why? Because this house has an awkward facing angle, facing windows, so they can't really shoot you too well. And look at this. My guys are wasting away at them. These are my pioneers coming in from the side. These are going to be trying to flank them. So you always have to remember, try and flank. Don't always go for a direct route, because that's where all the gunfire is coming from. Always go around, so try and flank them, so you don't take as much casualties, so you can be successful in your attack. Here comes flamethrower. Whoa! Whoosh! He has to get out of there. Now, I don't know, do you guys want to take a look at... I wish you guys could tell me if you want to take a look at LtAirborne's Airborne's abilities. Well, might as well, I suppose, right? Just gonna quickly pause. LtAirborne Airborne, he's an airborne commander, obviously. He's got airdrop smoke, so you've seen that going down to my MGs a bit. That just makes him have reduced accuracy. He's got airdrop supply drops, air reconnaissance. He should be using this all the time to see what I'm doing in my base. Airborne paradrop, and he's got strafing run. So pretty standard abilities for the airborne commander. And we'll switch on back over to me. And keep on going. So on this, at this time of the game, I've got, let's see, two pioneers, three Volks Grenadiers. Actually, no, I've got three. Yeah, I've got three pioneers. My bad. Sorry, guys. I've got three Volks Grenadiers, and I did actually have a Fallen HMG, but if you notice, that died in the beginning. That was only due to my rustiness, I assure you. I'm not lying. But, you know, if that didn't die, I'd still have an FMG, or a Fallen MG on the field. But say if your MG dies like that, just build another one, it's no big loss, and it will actually help a lot. So right now, Lieutenant Airborne's just being smart, he's flanking me, you saw that, so he comes here, he goes around there, just like what I do to him. And at the same time, my medics are always grabbing my units. And that is if they actually get away with them as well. So here I've just got my MG setting up, always fighting, and here again, this is what you have to realize, these Hero Gladiator Riflemen, the Hero Riflemen are always going to come in close and try to throw grenades at your MGs, so always be careful of that, be wary. And at the same time, always capping on each side of the map, and this is a feature, like Harlequin likes to say, this is a feature that you'll see in pro games. That there will be action constantly going on, that there will be capping on all sides of the map at all time, just action constantly.